Today we will be discussing about the fifth chapter, which is ledger. Now let us see what exactly is ledger. Now we said accounting, you have studied what is accounting. In accounting you said there is the word as identifying, okay, recording, and you have also seen there is a word classifying. Now this word classifying is what we are doing in this chapter called ledger. Now in this chapter, or what we say preparation of ledgers, we classify the accounts after recording. Now in recording we have seen that you have applied the rule of debit and credit, and you have written the journal entries. Now once you have completed writing the journal entries, we say that, let us take for example one journal entry. If I write my journal entry as cash account debit to capital account, so if I have this journal entry, in this journal entry there are two aspects, or we say two heads, simple to understand, two different names. Now these two different names we have identified as one account each. For example, we say cash is one account and capital is one account. So in ledger what we will be doing is we will be collecting wherever the cash is debited or credited at one place under the heading cash. Similarly, we will be collecting the information relating to capital. So in some transactions capital might be credited, some cases it might be debited. So therefore we will collect all these amounts pertaining to capital at one particular place. So that is why we say ledger is a summary of transactions relating to one particular head. So that is the technical usage of the word ledger. Now let us see the other features of ledger. Now ledger literally means page in Latin language. Ledger literally means page in Latin language. Now next is what we do. It is also called as book of secondary entry. Now the book of primary entry is journal, because a transaction is first recorded in journal. Now what we do in this book of secondary entry? Okay, we transfer of entries from journal to concerned accounts in ledger. So what we do, the journal entries which we have written in the journal, we take one aspect of the transaction and it might have got affected several times. So we collect all where it has got affected and collect under the head of that particular aspect. We have already have given the example of cash to capital as one journal entry for which